Philadelphia Electric filed in April a new electric service tariff with the PUC in Harrisburg, resulting in savings of $2,564,000 to our customers. The reduced rates, in line with efforts to help attract new industry to southeast Pennsylvania, were mostly a benefit to industrial customers, although residential customers, some 14,000, who are heavy users of electricity, also shared in the saving. This was a second major rate reduction within 2 years. In 1963, a rate reduction of $3,800,000 was shared by 296,000 residential and small commercial customers. Dependable service at reasonable rates. This becomes the axiom for progress, for growth, for, as always, future planning. On the Susquehanna, the future is being shaped in part by the concept of muddy run. A description construction men feel barely describes the sticky, gummy soil edging the banks of the river. Muddy Run is the largest such project under construction in the United States. A massive engineering feat that will see a huge reservoir take form behind a dam 4,400 feet in length. This vast pumped storage generating plant is scheduled to begin operation by mid-1967. At that time, two of the 8 units will produce power, the remaining 6 units by June of 1968. Muddy Run posed engineering problems of some magnitude. Here, a 700-foot cofferdam was built 8 feet above the river flood levels so that construction men could proceed from a dry work area. Muddy Run, in combination with Conowingo, will put to full advantage the Susquehanna's water supply. During periods of low demand for electricity, water will be pumped from the river to the reservoir 400 feet above the powerhouse. Use of off-peak power for the pumping makes efficient use of steam plant power available elsewhere in the system. So, very much like a gigantic storage battery, Muddy Run on completion will be called on to furnish power economically during times of peak demand. Down the river from Muddy Run, construction of the Peach Bottom Atomic Power Station was substantially completed in 1965. The first fuel elements were delivered early in the year. The forward design of this helium-cooled reactor and nuclear supply system makes this the first atomic plant of its kind in the world, designed to produce steam at temperatures and pressures high enough to take advantage of the utility industry's modern generating station technology. 52 other investor-owned utilities, along with the U.S. Atomic Energy Commission, have assisted in the research and development work in this prototype installation. Philadelphia Electric owns and will operate the plant. The Peach Bottom Atomic Information Center has become an outstanding attraction among the many interesting and historical sites in this area. Here in a beautiful, up-to-date building, automated exhibits and displays tell the story of the atom and how nuclear energy is used for the production of electric power. As of the end of 1965, nearly 175,000 persons visited the center, coming from every state in the nation and from 60 foreign countries. Congressman Chet Hollowfield of California, speaking in March before the Joint Committee on Atomic Energy, of which he is chairman, said to Philadelphia Electric President R.F. Gilkerson,
"I want to commend you and your associates for the fine job of public relations. I know of no finer job of public relations that's been done around any of these reactors than has been done in your case. You have really done a fine job."